Welcome to the second Mars Ice Challenge, hosted here at NASA Langley Research Center, where 10 teams from universities across the nation are competing to see who can extract the most water from simulated subsurface ice. This competition addresses one of the many challenges of sustaining human life on Mars. There are no convenience stores to run to for a bottle of water on Mars. However, water trapped in ice deposits below the surface has been found in regions around the red planet. Technologies being developed now will enable astronauts to extract existing water from within the planet. These 50 engineering students have designed and built prototypes, leading the way in developing water extraction systems for Mars. Taking into account the differences between Earth and Mars, including temperature, power limitations, and atmospheric pressure.
I am really excited to see our system in action. We are using a couple innovative pieces that no other team here is doing. For example, we're using an inductive heater. So what that, it's like an inductive stovetop. It resonates a magnetic field to heat up the ice. And what we're doing, instead of just melting the ice into water and collecting it, we're boiling it into steam and then distilling it and bringing it back into water, which will give us really pure water. So we think if NASA actually sent a mission to Mars, this is something they would do, especially because the pressure is even lower. It's easier to sublimate the ice. So we're really excited to see this design in action.
During our tests, our overburden was a little bit drier than the overburden is here. So it's slightly more moist, which works entirely in our favor. So our hole is really holding well. We were having problems with that caving in, no problem there. And we're extracting right now. We've gotten past our kind of dirty water that you have at the interface between the ice and the dirt. And so now we're pumping beautiful, clear water. It's going very well. We also had some issues with our filtration chamber last night where it was leaking a little bit, but it's going fine, no leaks. We redesigned it a little bit, so everything's going really great, actually. I think there's a really good kind of atmosphere of camaraderie, actually. We've really gotten to know the other teams. I mean, it's a competition, but it doesn't really feel very heated or anything like that. Obviously, you know, we all want to get as much water as we can, but it's been a good time. Everybody's really nice. All the people who are running it are really nice. There's a lot of knowledge to go around, which is really great. So that's probably the most, I guess, cool thing about a competition.
Competitions like this are really a win-win scenario. NASA gets a chance to look at a whole bunch of options that they hadn't considered before, find the things that work, find the things that don't, and really focus it. At the same time, it's a win for the universities because they help generate their students, give them practical experience that will help them get careers in the future.
After 2 days of drilling, first place was awarded to Northeastern University for the most water collected, and second to the West Virginia Midas II team.